So, quick change of venue then. It's the old Roan chase now at Aintree. And it's a 2.5 mile grade 2 handicap. This one on the top one is Confessions of an Assassin for Paul Rhodes. Vintage Trader, Leon van Rensburg. Cheeks Gold for Craig Allen. International Rescue for Paul Rhodes. Shining Bright, Craig Beckwith. The Killer Queen, Joshua Sutherland. Rally Gazelle for John Morgan. El Sophia Miller for Thomas Rogers. Around Regal for Martin Leedham. Long Haul for Graham Clutterbuck. Eleanor Rigby for Martin Leedham, a winner last week. Alsada Shine for Ryan Costello. Heron Island, Terry Hansen. And Edge 4 Freeze, Thomas Rogers. So just the one winner in this then. One previous winner. Obviously there'll only be one winner in this at the end, unless it's a dead heat, of course. And there'll be two. After that, away they go then. And after that statement of the obvious by me, we're racing towards the first of the fences here on our first trip, I believe, to Liverpool for this season. Which is where we'll be ending the season as well, of course. And International Rescue is just about the leader at the moment. And Paul Rhodes could probably do with an International Rescue for his jumps team, really, because there have been a lot of fallers in the earlier races at Cheltenham. He's spending lockdown watching lots of old Thunderbirds episodes, by the looks of it, as they get to the first. And there's a faller already there, and it's a round Regal. So the Red Rum Silks were victorious in the final race today at Cheltenham. They're not very victorious back at Liverpool, where they became most famous, because they're on the deck and all muddy already, and Around Regal is now four in his first three races. So I've got a feeling that one might be heading for the hurdles next week as they take number three then. And Ryan Costello's Alsada Shine gave that one a bit of a wallop, but they've settled down now, and a rather big crowd. It's almost like a Grand National Day crowd, isn't it? Cheeks Gold, Vintage Trader, and International Rescue are disputing the lead as they get over number four. And there's another faller. Edge 4 Freeze has gone this time. So Edge 4 Freeze is out of the race as well. I think that's Thomas Rogers. But it's Vintage Trader who's in the lead. From Cheeks Gold second and International Rescue third. Then a little bit of a gap to Rally Gazelle in the pale blue jacket in fourth. And that one's inside is Shining Bright. Confessions of an Assassin is closest to us as they take number five. Really good jump there by Eleanor Rigby, who won the Starters Orders heat last week and is now qualified for the final, which is to be run at this track in week 13. And International Rescue over that one in front, out jumped there by Cheeks Gold. And Cheeks Gold is about a length and a good, but International Rescue is pretty keen to be in front and is battling back to take a share of it. They come past the big screen then, and they take this one. That'll be the last on the next circuit as they get over that one. The remaining runners are all safely on their feet and they'll be passing the winning post. There it is, and International Rescue is passed it first on the first circuit, but we'll be more interested in passing it first on the second circuit. Gets onto the inside rail, that turn there that a lot of people complain about, saying it's too sharp, but it's International Rescue who's clear by four now, to Cheeks Gold in second, and then El Sophia Miller, and then Shining Bright, and then Long Haul. Then comes Confessions of an Assassin and Vintage Trader. Rani Gazelle is next. Eleanor Rigby being covered up in the middle of the pack. The back three at the moment are the Killer Queen, Alsada Shine, who's made a bit of ground, and Heron Island, who is the back marker. And the leader is still International Rescue. Looks like we're going to go jockey camming for a bit again. Of the Killer Queen, Joshua Sutherland's horse, as they see them over this fence. And the graphic at the top there tells us that it jumped it good. Eleanor Rigby, the one who won last week, and she jumped it slowly, so not so good that time. Confessions of an Assassin there comes up to this next one and jumps it slowly as well, so the cameraman picking some bad jumps. I feel like I'm a show jumping commentator today. It's International Rescue now then. Oh no, it's Rally Gazelle. They're coming to this next one. Rally Gazelle being driven into it and jumped that one well. Well, jumped it good anyway. I'm pretty sure there's a graphic that says you've jumped it fast as well. Anyway, back to the race. It's Cheeks Gold in the lead and International Rescue on the outside. Just been snatched up there. All Shining Bright almost ran into the back of Cheeks Gold. It's now been just pulled around the outside as they come to this next one. They've only got three furlongs to go now, and that was the third last. So all that jockey camming has sort of left us a little bit out of the race, but now they're racing away from us now, and it's Cheeked Golden International Rescue from Shining Bright in third. Then comes the Killer Queen in fourth as they get to the second last. Over it they go. They're all safely over it, and it's up the top end. It's Cheeked Gold. Cheeked Gold from International Rescue and Shining Bright. Quite a few of these have not gone into this race at all. Cheeked Gold is in front. Cheeked Gold is about a length and a half up. Got one more to jump and a very short running. Cheeked Gold comes into this final fence in the old Roan chase. Comes up to it nicely. Gets over it. Pops it while the rest jumped it really slowly. And Cheeked Gold is going to steal this move from the front. I think Cheeked Gold is going to take it up towards the line. Cheeked Gold is indeed the winner. Shining Bright second. Then Rally Gazelle. Long haul. Confessions of an Assassin after that one. Heron Island is going to be the last one to finish. And the crowd are frozen in surprise as Cheeked Gold takes it by probably 3 lengths. A ridiculous 40-1. And there it is then. Cheeked Gold takes it for Craig Allen. Shining Bright for Craig Beckwith was second. Rally Gazelle for John Morgan was third. Long Haul for Graham Clutterbuck fourth. And Confessions of an Assassin for Paul Rhodes was fifth.